Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So the NABARD Grade A 2020 notification is finally out. So the prelims dates have been announced and the online registrations are open, right? So in this particular video, let's just discuss when is the exam going to be held and what are the important parameters like the eligibility criteria, what is the exam structure, and we'll also see some of the important points that we are usually confused about, right? So here we have just taken a screenshot from the official notification. So you can see that applications are invited from Indian citizens for the post of assistant manager in grade A in RDBS, that is Rural Development Banking Service, and you can see Rajbhasha Service, Legal Service, right? So there is also generalist post as well as a specialist post. We'll see the number of vacancies as well. So friends, the online registration dates, if you see, 15th Jan, the registrations are open, that is today onwards, and it will go on till 3rd of Feb 2020. So I would recommend that fill your forms as soon as possible. Do not delay it further. The exam date is 25th of Feb 2020, the prelims examination date. So here is a list of vacancies. You can see that if you talk about the generalist post under RDBS, there are totally 69 vacancies that are out. And if you see the total vacancies that are out for RDBS, it is 139 plus 4 vacancies for persons with disabilities, right? So this is how the vacancies are split. And when you talk about the specialist post, you can go through the list and see the corresponding educational qualification requirement and then apply accordingly, right? And further, if you see in the generalist post also, there are reservations that are there. Unreserved, there are 26 seats, and SC 10, ST 5, OBC 19. There's also the other category, that is EWS, economically weaker sections. Okay, so for that, 9 seats have been reserved. So this is how the split up is. Please make sure that you see where you fall in exactly. Then friends, coming to the eligibility criteria in terms of education, so let's just see some important points here. First of all, when you talk about how much percentage you should have scored, a minimum, if you see 50% in case of the general category, and the other categories SC, ST, P, WBD, applicants 45%. So if you see, OBC also would require 50% minimum marks to be eligible to apply for this particular post, right? And they have also specifically mentioned for postgraduate degree, but there is no difference as such in marks. You can see the minimum mark is again 50%, right? So please make sure you check your eligibility before you go ahead and apply for this particular post, right? Further friends, here is an important information that you need to note, that the candidate must possess the required educational qualification as on 1st of January 2020. This is very important point. So if you're still giving your final examination, you are not eligible to apply for this post. Okay, so please make sure, I'm repeating myself, if your final results are awaited, you are not eligible to apply. Okay, I would read that line again so that I re-emphasize this fact. The result of the final term, semester, year examination of the required education qualification must have been declared on or before 1st 2020, right? 1st of Jan 2020. So here again, they have specified the candidates whose final results have been declared after 2nd of January 2020 are not eligible to apply. Okay, then the other thing, this point is for those people who are going to apply for the specialist post. Okay, so you can see that the candidate must have studied that discipline as a main subject in all the semesters or years of their respective degree. Okay, so this is an important point. So make sure you cross verify before you go ahead and tick the specialist post category while filling the application form, right? Next, talking about age. Now, this is again a very crucial, because we were not expecting the NABARD notification to be out in this particular month. So we were expecting it nearly, you can say, April or May. So again, the cycle has changed a bit. So read this particular eligibility criteria very properly. The candidate must be between 21 and 30 years of age, that we all know. But as on 1st of January 2020. So because of this date, many of them would still be eligible to apply for this examination. So you can say it's a kind of an added advantage here. Okay, so read this eligibility criteria and accordingly go ahead with the application form. Next, talking about the relaxations in the upper age limit, if you see for the OBC applicants, there's 3 years of relaxation, and the applicants belonging to SC, ST, 5 years of relaxation is given in the age, 10 years for persons with disabilities in the general category, 13 years for persons with disabilities under OBC category, 15 years for persons with disabilities SC, ST applicants. So this is how the split up is. So see if you fall under any of these particular relaxations, right? Now, talking about the exam structure of NABARD Grade A, it is a three-tiered examination. You have phase 1, phase 2, and interview. Just to make things clear, the phase 1 examination is just qualifying in nature. When the final result is out, phase 2 marks and the interview marks are taken together. Here you can see the pattern of phase 1. So objective type questions, simple, 120 minutes and total marks 200. Okay, there is no sectional timing here. Okay, sectional cutoff is there. We will see later about that as well. So you can see the different sections that are there in your phase 1 examination. One is your test of reasoning, which is for 20 marks. You have English language, 40 marks. Computer knowledge, 20 marks. General awareness, 20. Quantitative aptitude 20, ESI with focus on rural India 40 marks, ARD with focus on rural India again 40 marks. So friends, here if you have a close look at this particular pattern, there's an added advantage in case you're not very good in reasoning, quant or English, because three sections if you take, economics and social issues, agriculture and rural development, plus your general awareness, it constitutes 100 marks out of a total of 200. So 50% of your job is done if you're good in these three sections. Plus, when you're preparing for ESI and ARD for phase 1, do it parallelly for phase 2 as well. Do not demarcate the preparation for phase 1 separately and phase 2 separately, right? So please make these things very clear. Moving ahead for your phase 2 pattern, you can see that phase 2 is for 200 marks. There are going to be two papers. The first paper is a general English paper. That's a descriptive paper, the only descriptive paper in fact in the entire examination. 100 marks, 90 minutes. You can see that in the notification, they have clearly mentioned the components that you would be tested upon when you talk about descriptive English. Okay, so there is essay writing. There is comprehension, there is report writing, there is paragraph writing and letter writing. So you can see that the components have been clearly mentioned. So what we need to do here, when we are preparing for the examination, we need to be very sure that we know the rules and we are practicing these topics that have been mentioned very clearly in your notification, right guys? The paper 2, if you talk about, it has two components, ESI, economic and social issues, plus ARD, agriculture and rural development. It's worth 100 marks for 90 minutes, right? Again, I'm re-emphasizing the fact that when you're preparing for ESI and ARD, do it parallelly for your phase 1 and phase 2, right? Next, the third thing that you have, the final stage is the interview stage, and you have 25 marks for your interview. So let's just see some important points here. You need not worry about the calling ratio, but still they have mentioned, so I've highlighted here that for mains exam, it is 1:25. The more important point that I would like to stress here, that you have negative marking, okay? So for every wrong answer that is marked, 1/4 of the marks that is assigned to that question will be deducted as penalty, okay? So this is going to be the case for objective type questions, obviously, for your phase 1 and your phase 2. And the cutoff is not only overall, there's also going to be sectional cutoff even in phase 1 and phase 2. In phase 2 also, paper-wise cutoff would be there. So do not get confused, one overall cutoff and the paper-wise cutoff. You need to clear both these things to see your names in the final list, right? Now, the other important things that we need to have a look at, if you talk about the interview, the calling ratio would be 1:5. And as I earlier I have mentioned this, that the prelims examination is qualifying in nature, right? When you are shortlisted or your final list is there, it would be depending on your mains mark plus your interview marks, okay? So that's very important. Further, they've also given this point that in case there is a tie, So what we need to do, so you can see the first point, among the candidates having equal marks in total, that is mains plus your interview, the candidates who have the highest mark in mains examination will be ranked higher. Okay, so this is again important. So your mains examination has a leverage there. Okay. Okay, now this important point I need to tell you all, because many of you would be confused regarding the same. If you are applying for the generalist post, you cannot apply for another discipline and vice versa. So it is not that you can apply for generalist plus you can go in for a specialist post. That is not allowed here. Okay. So once you are filling your form for the generalist post, that's it. You can only apply for one post. Okay. The same goes across the various categories also. So if you are applying for RDBS, you cannot apply for Rajbhasha and legal and vice versa. So please make sure you do not get disqualified unnecessarily by filling more than one form. In case you fill more than one form also, your latest form will be taken into account and you will be eligible to go in only for that particular category. Okay. Again, if you talk about the specialist post also, you can fill it only for one post or discipline of your choice. You cannot go in for two disciplines. That also need to be taken care of, right? So friends, before you go ahead, fill your forms. These are some of the important details you need to sit back and have a look at. Okay. So what are the courses that we are offering for NABARD 2020? So EduTap has complete course packages here. If you talk about grade A, we have phase 1 full video plus phase 2 full video. You have phase 1 mock test plus phase 2 full video. Then there is phase 1 mock test plus phase 2 non-video course. So on all these courses, we are offering a 15% off. So in order to avail that particular discount, you need to use a coupon code EARLY50. And in case you are our old subscribers, then you need to drop us a mail at hello@edutap.co.in and we'll give you a coupon code because you're eligible for a 30% off, right? And we are also offering combo courses. You can buy NABARD along with RBI and SEBI. There is RBI NABARD together, there is SEBI and RBI, and NABARD and SEBI together as well. So again, the same thing, we have a 15% off on it. You need to use the coupon code EARLY15. And again, if you are our old subscribers, please do drop in a mail at hello@edutap.co.in to get the coupon code because you are eligible for a 30% off. We do have individual courses for RBI Grade B as well, SEBI Grade A, RBI Assistant, IBPS, CFO, and also separate courses for Quant, Reasoning and English. That is going to be useful for all the banking examinations. So friends, in case you have any query, just feel free, just give us a call at 814-620-7241. You can drop in a mail at hello@edutap.co.in. In case you want to have a look at the courses that we offer, just visit our website www.edutap.co.in. So thank you so much, friends. Please go through the application form, and in the description box of this video, we'll also place the link of the form and as well as the notification. Okay. So have a look at it, see if you're eligible, and then go ahead, apply as soon as possible. Do not keep delaying, and all the best for your preparations. We'll be there guiding you all through. Right. Thank you so much and happy learning.